pronunciation of this young lady?
No. I'm sorry. Right. I don't think she's playing. Is that our girl?
Yeah.
No, she's not acting.
Okay.
Thank you.
test, test, test.
So about a minute and 30 seconds from now.
It's already up.
Okay, cool. Good afternoon, Jaguars Nation. A game that is 20 years is in the making. We'll tip off the 2021 season of basketball here at Christenberry Fieldhouse. Welcome to Augusta University Athletic Campus. I'm the Mac Daddy, Charles McNeil, alongside normally AU alum Chad Cook. He is doing some other assignments for AUG B-Ball right here in this facility, so I am running solo. This series dates back to 1975 when Augusta College and our opponents Georgia Southern played a home-and-home series over the years through 1991. They took an eight-year break and then renewed the matchup in 2000. So after a two-decade break, the Division II Jaguars and Division I Eagles women are back on the hardwood. This is a very significant game, one that means a lot to both programs, the renewal of the rivalry, the opportunity for Georgia Southern players, Maya Burns out of North Augusta, and Jaden Hamilton out of Laney High School here in Augusta, to embark and play in a game that means a lot to them as their home. And unfortunately for them, Augusta University Athletics has decided, due to COVID-19 and the increased risk to the athletes and students here on campus, there will be no fans in attendance for any of its athletic contests and events through January 1st. GSU won the last meeting 94-45. The Lady Eagles lead the series 19-2 and have won 14 straight in this series. Coach Millette Green, you know what she's thinking about right about now, and that is the start of a new season, an opportunity to build on the success of last year, and they won three of their final four games, and a chance to move forward toward the ultimate goal, a Peach Belt Conference championship, and an opportunity to advance into the NCAA tournament. AU's two victories in this series came in back-to-back meetings over two seasons. They both were played here in Augusta on February the 8th, 1978. It was an 81-75 victory. And just about a little bit over a year before that, January 3rd, 1979, 72-69, the victory for Augusta University as we pause for the national anthem. We're preparing ourselves for the 22nd meeting of AU and GSU, the 10th matchup in the Garden City, and the Eagles lead the series when played right here in Augusta, Georgia, 7-2. Head-to-head, the Eagles averaging 75.5 points a game, Jaguars averaging 55.8 points a game when they play head-to-head. The closest game in this series was in 1986. When Augusta lost that contest 64-63, and Augusta coming off of an awesome year in which they won 12 contests, including three of their final four. They finished 9-11 in Peach Belt Conference play as they watched two of the great teams in the league rise to the top. Of course, no one getting an opportunity to play in the NCAA tournament, as that was postponed and canceled. So the visitors being announced first. And it's a young group. Anita Howard in her second year running the Eagles women's program, a graduate of Armstrong Atlantic State in 2003. That school merged with Georgia Southern in 2017. She's the eighth head coach in Georgia Southern history, the first African-American female head coach in Statesboro. And Howard's name will be a familiar one to Jaguar fans around the globe, as she was the coach at Columbus State for three seasons. With the Cougars, Coach Howard was 66-25, 45-18 in the Peach Belt, including two NCAA Division II championship game appearances, and one trip to the Elite Eight. Last season, Georgia Southern was 10-20 overall, 7-11 in the Sun Belt. While this record isn't what Howard is used to by any stretch of the imagination, they were some outstanding accomplishments, including 44-point win versus Winthrop and her first road win as head coach at Georgia Southern, and a school record 14 made three-pointers in a victory over Louisiana. Of course, she prides herself on defense, being a fierce all-conference defender at Fort Valley State and Armstrong Atlantic. She has eight newcomers joining her roster of seven veteran members for the Eagles. that won 5 more Sun Belt Conference games than a year ago. Augusta University also excelling, as we mentioned, with those 9 victories in Peach Belt Conference play. It's Division I versus Division II in this one, and it's the opener of our coverage of the 2020-21 season. AUGB ball making it possible. Kennedy Manning set to do the tip. And the tip is up, and it's headed our way, and we will get the opening tip right in our laps, as that's the way it goes when Augusta sets their lineup with number 30, November Morton. She is a newcomer to the team, the 5'10 junior on the inbounds. Kiera Howard running the point duties. In the post is Manning. To work the ball around, you've got Zaria West, number 0. And the last of the 5 on the floor is Ashley Boland. Turn around and face. Off the glass, no good, and rebounded by Georgia Southern. They're sporting what was their camouflage uniforms at the start in their pregame warm-ups. Now moving to the gray with the gold underneath as they get it in low, and they score a basket. The opening hoop score by number 41, that's Eden Johnson. Johnson is a redshirt freshman, 6'2", 12 points, 3 rebounds. 5 of 6 shooting from the field against Jacksonville State in their opening loss of the year. We'll talk to that a little bit more. It's top of the circle, jump shot in the air, and it's good. Knocking down the field goal was number 30, that's Shondell Vickers. So Vickers comes in, 6'2", sophomore power forward, Florida Southwestern State transfer, and we'll get into her a little bit more as we move along. On the perimeter, it's Morton. Back up top into the hands of Howard. Howard surveying the defense as they're operating in a 2-3 zone with man principles as they drive the lane, and there's a whistle and a foul as Ashley Boland will get an opportunity to put Augusta on the board for the free throw line. Boland, the 5'10 sophomore out of Lawrenceville, Georgia, Duluth High School. She was a player that flashed some brilliance as a rebounder extraordinaire. And hustle points were a large portion of when she was on the floor. Set spins and fires on the first one, and it's good. So Augusta's on the board. They cut the lead to 4-1. We're just underway, first quarter of this contest. Boland, second one in the air. It is pure. So lead is cut in half just that quickly, and we've got our first subs off the bench. Jalea Gray checks in for Augusta University, as does another teammate, and they'll try to figure out who that is as Morton checks out. And I think they'll settle on that being the only change they'll make. Now they break the press with these, take the ball to the basket. There's a whistle and a foul. Janaya Love Hill goes to the line. She's a 5'6 sophomore out of Columbus. Scored most of her points the other night in that 71-58 loss to Jacksonville State. She wound up scoring most of her points at the free throw line, where she was 4 of 4 before that miss on the season. Georgia Southern, 0-1 on the year. Augusta playing their first contest and really moving up in class to play a D1 school out the gate. So 5-2 is our score. Augusta breaks the press. Working on the perimeter. Jalen Altman has it. She came in for Ashley Boland as they work the passing game. That's Howard. Dribble drive. Looking for help. Double team. Kicks it out to the open man. Now they get it down low to Manning. Turns and face. Now kicks over the other side for a perimeter 3 in the air. And they said stepped on the sideline out of bounds. Did Howard. So another turnover for Augusta. Score remains 5-2, 7 minutes 51 seconds left to go in the opening quarter. Into the front court. Tatum Barber. Now dribble drive, and there's a push underneath. Defensive foul set against Augusta. As we got another Augusta sub into the ball game, and it's another newcomer. Michaela Lane checks in. Out of Trenton, New Jersey, by way of Matthews, North Carolina. She's a freshman. Augusta increasing their height this year. As the perimeter jump shot rattles off, no good. That was Atiana Golden. Golden. Now a three ball in the air. That side rim, no good. Tipped, but out of bounds first. It'll be Augusta basketball. Just trailing by one field goal. 5-2. Low scoring affair just underway from the Christenberry Fieldhouse. And the inbounds. Working against the pressure. Get it to the middle. And now they broke the press. They can get in their offensive set. Right side. That's West. Up top in the hands of Gray. Gray goes over to Altman. Altman looking for help. Now she'll spin dribble. Drive to the lane. Pull up jump shot off glass. No good. Loose ball rebound and pulled out of there. And here comes Golden. Golden to the basket and a kick. And they're going to see a push down low. And that goes against Altman. That's Augusta's 13th foul, only one thus far against Georgia Southern. As another sub comes into the off the bench, and that's the return of November Morton. And we've got a legal screen on the weak side. Still pressure being put on by Georgia Southern, broken by Augusta University. Ball tipped away. Asia Harrison now in the lineup. She was a stalwart on her team last year, had 11 points in last year's finale against North Georgia. She's on the floor, some instant offense off the bench, and she gets the inbound. West, explosive score. Harrison looking for help, now dumps it down low. First attempt, no good. Second try off glass. Contact, no whistle. And back they come the other way. Contact down low, the turnaround. Now the dump pass in the post. Lay it off glass, no good. Rebounded by Augusta. Here comes Harrison. She's got numbers. Kicks it on the right wing. Extra pass to Morton. Lining up a three. Yes! November Morton, prolific scorer, averaging 21 points in her high school. That was a school record at her high school in Tampa, Florida. Graduated summa cum laude and also won 3 district titles. So the epitome of a student athlete is November Morton. We're deadlocked at 5. Ashley Bullen checks in, and Gray will check out. So Augusta goes man on the inbound. They're working in the post. Layup off glass. Count it, and a foul. That's Sarah Moore. Sarah listed at 6'1", but looks a lot taller than that. Moore will toe the line, the senior out of Tampa, and knocks it down. So that gives the Eagles back the lead, 8-5 at the 5:47 mark. Harrison working it with plenty of time on the shot clock. She brings it across. And now they'll bring it up top. Looking down low is Morton. Can't find anybody. Goes right side in the hands of West. On the wing, it's Lane. Back up to West. West back to Lane. She's going to pull up again. Side rim, no good. Pull it past in the low post and a traveling violation on the bunny hop. Zaria West will now check out as back comes in Kiara Howard. They're going to use Lane to help bring it across. Into the hands of Harrison. Loses something behind. There's Lane to pick it up. Now on the wing. Lane, an excellent ball handler for her height on the floor. Harrison has Lane in the post. She wants it. Harrison drives. Now kicks it. Bounce pass in the low post. Now they kick it on the wing. Extra pass on the right side. Nothing happening there. Dribble drive. And we've got contact on the weak side. That'll be a foul committed by Georgia Southern. We've got a timeout on the floor. It comes with 4:49 left to play in the opening quarter. And Augusta trailing by 3. Coach Millette Green working the sidelines as she prepares following the timeout. We've got 4:49 left to play, opening quarter, and Augusta throws it off the back of the backboard, and that's not something you want out of a timeout right there. So turnover gives the ball back to the Eagles. Moving left to right across your screen. And they'll go with a tall guard to bring it up this time, and nearly a steal. Bolin nearly came away with it. Instead, they get it down low for a layup, and it's good. Simone James with her first field goal. Freshman out of San Diego, 5'10". Immediately paying dividends. They bring the ball up top, and they'll work the perimeter. Now the dribble drive, right wing. Jump shot in the air, back iron, no good. Rebounded and pulled out of there by Howard. Howard on the drive to the basket after West was the one who came up with the loose ball. Make that. Yeah, I was correct the first time. It's Howard over to Harrison who had this jump shot. 10-5 is our score. Now the dribble drive. Strong one it was. Shot attempt a little bit short of the mark. Now they kick it out to the free throw line. Jump shot in the air. It's Sarah Moore with another field goal. She's got 5. And this is the largest lead in the ball game for Georgia Southern. They're up 12-5. Right after Augusta tied it up at 5 apiece. A 7-0 run for Georgia Southern and the Lady Eagles. Down low, Ashley Bolin stops and pops and drops. But Bolin with another field goal. She has 4 in the game. 12-7 is our score. 3:14 left. Naz Moore, free throw line, front iron no good. Rebounded by those long arms. That's Maya Burns. You remember her. Come in the lane, drive off the glass, count it, and a foul. Aggressive move that time. Lacey Robbins with the basket. You might remember seeing that name in the local newspapers. Lacey Robbins, the 5A Georgia High School Player of the Year. Listed as a point guard off her 5'11 frame, she went to Statesboro High School. So a local product, stayed home. And unable to complete the three-point play, loose ball. Who wants it? Augusta has it, double-teamed in the backcourt. Now they get it off. Got limited amount of time to get it across the line. They do. West has it, and she'll slow things up. Now Lark left side. Go to the top of the circle, extra pass. Has Bolin in the post instead of pull up, and that's short of the mark. Then coming up the floor, there's a whistle, and that'll be against Gray for the contact. So plenty of versatility in this Georgia Southern squad with ball handlers galore as they really bring them up the floor and get them into the action. Maya Burns, tremendous player in our area, one of the all-time greats. McDonald's All-American, 6-foot, small forward. She's a sophomore. Her accolades go on and on. She was the 4A State Player of the Year, 3 state titles. Started 19 games in her freshman campaign. Averaged 5 points and 3 rebounds, 23 steals, and 16 block shots. They break the press, but no, it's stolen away. Now stolen back by Augusta. Down by 9. Looking to cut into it. Behind the back dribble. Now the kick. On the wing. Back up top. Gray has it. It's in the hands of West. Gray. Back to West. Now Kiara Howard will settle them down. Three seconds left on the shot clock. Shot attempt up. Side rim, no good. Rebounded, and here comes Georgia Southern. Augusta got back defensively, but they're going to take it to the house anyway. And drew contact, and a whistle means a foul against Augusta. And the opportunity to go to the line to add to their lead. Used all aspects of the rim on that one as Love Hill scores. Both of her points coming from the charity stripe. Second one in the air, and it bounds off no good. Rebounded inside by her teammate, and she scores. So Tatum Barber with her first field goal, 5'10 senior out of Dallas, Texas. Augusta breaks the press. Breaking press was a difficult task for them. As I look on the floor, and Jaden Hamilton is out there now, the superstar from Laney High School. Sophomore. Phenom. She was so excited to get on the floor back here at Augusta University as she leads her team down the court. But they've got to break a press, so now she comes back to help out. Jaden grabs it, but only for a moment as it's too high for her, and it goes out of bounds. one of the fiercest competitors to ever come through Laney was Jaden Hamilton. And there's a steal on the inbound, threw it right to her. Love Hill with her first field goal. She has four, 21-7. Now the lead is 14. Largest deficit was 16 so far in this one. Nice pass on the wing, and they're going to call a block underneath. Beautiful drive by Asia Harrison, and the dump to Ashley Bolin. If Bolin had been able to catch and shoot, that's automatic. Lydia Freeman just checked in. She's another of the freshman additions to Anita Howard's team. Don't see Coach Howard on the sidelines. She apparently did not make this trip. See if we get some insights on that at halftime. 6'5 freshman. She's underneath the basket. We'll talk about her, I'm certain, before the afternoon is done. But Howard's at the line where she knocks down the first. She's on the board. Going to definitely need her to be a productive scorer this year and consistent scorer for Augusta. Second one in the air, and it's good. Turnovers and free throws and outside scoring were some of the major needs as they get it in low, and there she is right on cue, Lydia Freeman. And you got a 6'5 player. You got to use her, and they did. She won three straight state titles at Westlake High School. An all-state product, first-teamer. There's Bolin. And as I said, automatic. If you get it to her right there, she's going to score. She's leading the scoring for Augusta with six of their 11 points in the game as we're inside the final 30 seconds of the first quarter. On the wing with 5 seconds. Dribble drive, Barber steps inside, takes an extra step, and travels. So Augusta get the ball with 3 seconds remaining and down by 12. West takes it near the half-court mark. There's contact, no whistle, and the first quarter comes to a close. So we played 10 minutes here at Christenberry Fieldhouse, and our score, the Eagles, 23. The Jaguars 11. This is the AUGB ball game of the week. And we bring you back in for the start of the second quarter. Augusta University, under the direction of Millette Green, in her fourth year, suffering through the loss of seniors Monisha Goldsboro and Cam Wilson. Also gone was the fabulous freshmen Crystal Corley, Madison Tyler, and Kristen Turner. But some outstanding newcomers to the lineup for Augusta, and they're hoping to pay major dividends as they get it in low again, and that's Freeman. So Freeman quickly inside of a minute, has two field goals. Their team is up by 14. Breaking the press on the wing is Morton. In the hands of West on the wing. That's Harrison for three. Rebounded by Freeman. Oh, my goodness. She enveloped that one. Got it in the hands of her teammate, and now she'll kick it back. She's going to try a three ball. If that dropped, I was about to leave this broadcast position. If she's got a three game to add to that post play, it would be a wrap in the Sun Belt. Outstanding job of recruiting by Georgia Southern to bring in some complimentary pieces to what they already had. As now Bolin will try to challenge the big. Inside, takes contact, gets a shot up, and she'll go to the line again to earn a couple from the charity stripe, where she's 2 for 2 thus far. Ashley Bolin out of Lawrenceville, Georgia, welcomed in a redshirt junior in Jalea Gray, also from Lawrenceville. Gray, number 12, not on the floor currently, but she's already seen some action. She is a Savannah State transfer. Bolin misfires on the first. Leading scorer in the contest for Augusta. She's a leading scorer for both squads with her 6 points, looking to make it 7. She knocks it down. There's Hamilton to the basket, no good. Loose ball rebound, and they'll say over the back for Georgia Southern. So Augusta doing a good job of boxing out inside and forcing the Eagles to go through them. West off to Morton. Morton kicks the ball out of bounds, and it'll go over. So the normally sure-handed Morton kicks the ball out of bounds, and it goes back. Another turnover for Augusta. Perimeter three in the air, and it's good. Knocking that one down is Taryn Ward. So everybody getting an opportunity to get in the game in this early going for Georgia Southern. And a lot of them are knocking down shots. 5'11 freshman out of Jessup, the co-player of the year for Wayne County High School, is Ward. 28-12, 16-point deficit, the largest for the second time in this game. Now pull up. High arcing jump shot brings down rain. That's Zaria West with the 2-point field goal. She had a fantastic junior campaign. Zaria West could score in bunches, and a lockdown defender as well. Senior out of Raleigh, North Carolina, transfer from Norfolk State. And we've got a hold on the part of Golden, who can't believe it. And the substitution will come in for her. And actually a couple of subs coming in. Jaden Hamilton also checking out. On the inbound, Simone James knocks it out of bounds. It'll be retained by Augusta. As Morton will trigger. No, it'll actually be West to do the honors. Set to inbounds. She needs help. Gets it to Ashley. Hit a head pass. Split job there for a moment. And Howard now retains possession. Goes left side. Into the hands of West. West to Howard. Kiera Howard with the drive. Kiera Howard, her first field goal, the junior, 5'5", out of McDonough, Georgia, and Eagle Landing High School. Now if they miss, one and done, as they are going small as far as the capabilities of Georgia Southern, so Augusta needs to take advantage of this opportunity with 7:10 left, down by 12. Chance to cut it down to single digits. Bowling. Passing game to the wing. Wide open. Three ball. No good by Howard. Right back the other way. They dump it down low. Now to the free throw line. Pump fake. Beautiful drive and a finish. That's Shondell Vickers. That's her second field goal. to 16, still a 14-point deficit. Get it down low. Lane tries to force up one, deflected away, and here they go. On the left wing, wide open three, and that's butter. Simone James, 5'10", freshman out of San Diego, forcing a timeout to be called by Augusta University head coach Millett Green. Point edge, the largest deficit so far. Hard to believe these two teams haven't met since the year 2000. In that last beating in Y2K, it was a 94-45 win for Georgia Southern. Checking out your individual scoring in this game. Ashley Boland leading the way for Augusta with 7 points. 2 points for West, 2 points for Harrison, 2 for Howard. And 3 for the newcomer, Morton. For the 16 on the board for Augusta. Georgia Southern, they've been paced by 5 points by James, 4 in the game for Freeman, 5 in the game for Moore, 2 for Johnson, 4 for Vickers, that's 2 for Barber. Love Hill has 4 points. 2 points for Robbins, 2 points for Burns, and 3 points for Ward for the 33 on the board for Georgia Southern. Grade to inbound. Gets it to Howard. West has it now. Races down toward the foul line, the dump off, they go cross court, and it's deflected away. That's Taryn Ward, right wing corner. Now they put it back in the hands of Love Hill. Foul line jump shot in the air. That was Tsubasa Nisbet with that last shot attempt. Now right back the other way. Now Lane, nice pass off to Howard, and she knows how to take it to the house and finish. Kiera Howard. Back the other way. Jump shot in the air. No good. Loose ball rebound. Augusta on the slow up. Check out exactly what they're working against. And that's a man-to-man defense. Bounce pass to the foul line. Lane grabs it and puts the vice grips on it, as Maya Burns was trying to get her hands on that one. So Michella Davis now checking in as Lane will check out. And the first free throw is just a little bit short. Second one off, no good as well. 15-point deficit. And Georgia Southern on the dribble drive. There's a whistle on the bump. And Davis picks up the foul. There's a steal into the front court. Kick it up top. Morton for three. Yes. November Morton knocking it down on this, the 28th day of her month. And right back the other way, they score. And that was Sarah Moore with her third field goal. She's got seven. So 35-21, 4:33 left in the opening half. From Christenberry Fieldhouse, the lone fans in attendance are members of the men's basketball program. No real fans were involved, no spectators involved in this one by way of paid entry. As you know, the men's and women's program show a lot of support for one another, and that's an unforced turnover by Georgia Southern. So the fellas had to come out and support the ladies in this opening matchup against Georgia Southern. Jaden Hamilton back on the floor. She tries to find her assignment. Howard has it for Augusta. Off it goes to Altman. Right side to Morton. Morton on the pull-up. Gets her own rebound. Plows through the defender and charges. Aggressive play, though. Coach Green not displeased by that at all. Aggressive following up on your own. And now we've got Asia Harrison Chunk coming back into the game, and she'll be spelling the talented Zaria West. There's Jaden Hamilton to the free throw line, right wing pass. Now they bring it back up top. Extra pass to the free throw line. Jump shot wide open and knocked down by Sarah Moore. That's her fourth field goal. She's got nine, and she likes the sight lines in this building. 37-21, 16-point lead for Georgia Southern as they're on the defensive side. Asia Harrison. Kiara Howard misfires. Rebound to Moore. Love Hill to the basket. Loses control of the basketball. Altman lost it for a moment. Picked up back there by Morton. Now it's Howard. Altman. Morton. Dribble drive and a kick. Altman, pull up. That's strong. Here comes Hamilton. All the way to the rack with the scoop. No good. Rebounded by Davis. The Jaguars need a basket. See if they can work the ball in the post to Davis. She wants it. She's got it down the post. Goes hard to the rack. There's a whistle before the shot attempt. And that'll go against Sarah Moore. That'll be her second. And here comes Lydia Freeman. So Michella Davis will step up to the line. Davis, now a junior from Lilburn, transfer from Lander University. Made one and missed one. She was injured at the start of last season. And now they try to get out on the wing, and there's Davis with the rebound. Fully healthy, and looks like she's fry with the legs as she comes up with that board. She gets down the floor for a quick lefty hook, and it's good. Michella Davis wanting to show her wares, and she is. 37-25. A 12-point deficit as we near the 90-second mark. Hamilton down low to Freeman, turning and facing off glass, and oh my. She's almost at the point of where you say you can't stop her, you can only hope to contain her, and we're only in the first half. 3-for-3 from the field for Freeman. Morton on the pull-up. Yes. Her first from two-point range, she's got 8. 39-27, back to a 12-point deficit. High arching jump shot, no good. Rebounded inside by Davis. Freeman comes in and commits the foul in the post, I do believe. And it will go against Freeman. And with them over the limit, Davis will go to the line. And now Freeman will check out. And back in to replace her is Vickers. Three points in the game for Davis. Takes a deep breath. Left-hander, deep knee bend. And that one's strong. So 12-point lead inside of a minute left on the wing. Jump shot up, no good. Followed up, blocked inside by Davis. And a foul committed. Oh, my goodness. Davis came in and swatted that one cleanly. So we've got substitution coming into the game. Not wanting to get Michella in foul difficulty. She'll take a seat. And to replace her is Michaela Lane. Vickers makes the second. She's got 5 now. 13-point lead. Morton and Asia Harrison running in the backcourt. They try to go up the floor, and they say 10-second violation as the ball touched the hands, but not before 10 seconds had crossed the clock. Hamilton inbounds. They're going to have a set play here. 2-second difference, and they're trying to go a 2-for-1, I do believe. But now the shot clock is off. Augusta may have the final shot of this opening half. On the wing, it's West. Up top, Morton. And they're going to call a foul against Bolin. And that's her first, team's fourth. Eagles with 5 team fouls here in the first half. Final 10 seconds of the opening half. Robbins behind the back dribble. Goes right side. Trying to drive past their man. Turn and face and ran out of time. So 20 minutes have been played here at the Chris and Berry Fieldhouse with a sparse few fans, namely the men's basketball program here to support the women who trail at the break to Division I Georgia Southern by 13. Your halftime score, the Eagles 40, the Jaguars 27, and you're watching the AUG B-Ball Game of the Week from Chris and Berry Fieldhouse in Augusta, Georgia. We'll be right back. Yeah. a voice behind the broadcast with Chad Cook, who's on assignment tonight. But we're pleased to bring you all the home games this season of Augusta University basketball, beginning right here with this one and throughout the Peach Belt Conference regular season as well. The men will be in action soon, and we'll fill you in on that as we move along in this broadcast. But we thank you so much for tuning in, and let's look at some of the numbers from the first half, beginning with the visitors. Georgia Southern, who leads it at the break, I mentioned 40-27. When I looked at my stat sheet, I had 26 there, and I brought that to the attention of the scorers, who also were looking at something similar, and it's actually 40-26 is the actual score. So Augusta trailing by 14 at the break. As for the visitors from Georgia Southern, Division I team out of the Sun Belt, they had 10 turnovers in the first half, 22 rebounds, 11 assists. They were 16 of 31 from the field, 2 of 9 from three-point range, and 6 of 10 from the charity stripe. As for Augusta University, they had 11 turnovers in the first half, 14 rebounds, only 4 assists. They were 9 of 25 from the field, 36%, 2 for 6 from three-point land, and 6 of 12 from the free throw line. So the things that stand out right away are the rebounding disparity. That's 8 in favor of Georgia Southern, and the assists, 7 more for the Eagles. Individual scoring from the top to the bottom for Augusta. You've got Zaria West with 2 points, 2 points for Asia Harrison. Kiara Howard has 4. 7 points in the game for Ashley Bolin. Jalea Grace played, did not score. Jalen Altman also has not scored. Kennedy Manning had a couple of quick fouls, and she did not score. November Morton with 8 points to lead the Lady Jaguars attack, and 3 points for Michella Davis. Many of you may be wondering about Stella Lavonier. I thought I saw her a little earlier. Don't see her now, but she was not in uniform, and she made her way onto the floor a little bit earlier. Yeah, I think she's actually on crutches. I see her to my left, headed toward the elevator to come on downstairs. So the second half is underway from the Christenberry Fieldhouse with Augusta down by 14. There's a pull-up jump shot to get things started. Zaria West on the board. Her second field goal, she's got 4. Now pull up from deep, and a knockdown 3 for Vickers. Give her 8. And more pressure by the Eagles. Man-to-man pressure as they bring it across. They've also run with a 2-2-1 press. Easily broken there by Howard. To the basket she goes. And there's a whistle and a foul committed by the Eagles. On the inbounds, they go to the wing for a three-point attempt. No good. And back come the Eagles. Nice looking low, and they score. Eden Johnson, her second field goal. She's got 4. She was 5 of 6 in their game against Jacksonville State, the 71-58 opening loss on the road. Next game for Georgia Southern will be Thursday, December 3rd, their home opener at Hanner Fieldhouse, as they'll take on Furman at 6 p.m. Right back at you, Ashley for 3. So Boland, the first player in double figures with 10. And there's a lost ball stolen away by Manning. And here comes Augusta. Pull-up jump shot, free throw line. Back iron, no good, off the backboard as well. Thought there was contact, no call. West not happy with it. Love Hill finds a teammate on the wing with a wild shot that went up there. I think that was Galden who attempted that one. Talk about terrific ball games. The Arkansas transfer with over 100 assists is number 0, who now checks out. She had 25 points, 5 rebounds, 3 assists, and made 4 three-pointers in 6 attempts in that game against Jacksonville State. Has yet to score in this one. Howard found West down to Manning, and there's a turn and a face. Manning looking to go to work. Third team All Peach Belt Conference performer is Manning, number 24. And she did that in her freshman campaign as she tries to knife in, finds a range. Short jump shot off the side of the rim, no good. Back comes Georgia Southern with a 14-point edge and looking to add to it on the right-hand scoop. No good, followed up inside and score. That's Vickers. 2 field goals for her. She's got all the offense for her team with the exception of Eden Johnson's field goal here in the second half. 2.5 minutes in. Boland being guarded by Vickers. Drives right by her. Lefty to layup. No good. Hits the floor. And back comes Georgia Southern. That's Love Hill to the rack with the right hand. No good. Manning keeps it alive and pulls down the board. West into the front court, surveying the defense, and now the right wing kick and knockdown shot by Morton. So November Morton showing some signs with 3 threes in this ball game. She's got 11. So 2 players for Augusta, Boland and Morton, with 11 and or 10 and 11 respectively. 47-34. See if we can come up with a defensive stand here. Could have been a double dribble, no call. Still double team in low as a block by Manning. Finds her teammate, Harrison. Hit ahead pass to Boland. Down the lane. Layup is up and good. And a foul. What an incredible move by Ashley Boland. Yeah, she penetrated off the lane without looking for the basketball in the last second. Pinpoint pass, caught it, threw it in over her back shoulder and scored the field goal. And now she'll get a chance to go to the free throw line following a timeout. In this new COVID era, we're seeing some things we have never seen before in our lifetimes, that is, and that's coaches who will have players, all 15 of them, seats separated by 6 feet on the respective sidelines, and then when it comes down to a timeout, they'll get into almost like a group picture, team picture being taken over there in the respective end zones, and when that happens, then the coach can pull out the chalkboard and begin to design plays and let them know exactly what they want to do. None of the players looking at one another. They're looking straight ahead to promote that aspect of social distancing. And coaches concentrating on things. It's a new environment that we're living in, and we pray that everyone is able to stay safe. Again, just to reiterate, the athletic department here at Augusta University under direction of Clint Bryant, deciding to forgo fans here in the facility until January 1st. No fans will be allowed in the events, but we will have coverage for you from the home site here at Christenberry Fieldhouse on the athletic campus of Augusta University. And we'll be more than happy to bring you live and exclusive coverage of Jaguar basketball, both on the men and women's side this year. So Ashley at the line, and she knocks it down. And Ashley Boland will check out, and Altman will come in to replace her. 6 points here in the second half, 7 in the first half for Boland. She's got 13. Game-high score on both sides as they work the ball to Jaden Hamilton on the offensive end. Double team, and now another one, and there's Augusta with a defensive stop. But the arrow pointing in favor of Georgia Southern, so they'll retain the possession. The good thing about that is the next held ball will go to Augusta. 6:02 left to go in the third. And the inbounds. Shot attempt up, no good. Loose ball, who wants it? Fighting for it, Georgia Southern. Ball deflected. It'll be last touched by Augusta. Ball set to trigger. There's a pump fake and a drive to the basket. Right-handed layup is good. Terrific move by Tsubasa Nismith. Nismith with the field goal. That's her first out of Christchurch, New Zealand. And there's a steal by the Eagles. Maya Burns out of North Augusta High School brings it up. Burns with the crossover move, can't finish. Nisbet with the rebound, and she takes an extra step. So our next broadcast will be on December the 5th when UNC Pembroke comes in, 5:30 contest, December 5th, UNC Pembroke, 5:30, and we'll have it for you right here. Perimeter jump shot, no good, followed up by Nismith. It's her second field goal, and Kennedy Manning missed with the right hand, goes with the left hand, and scores. Ambidextrous move right there by Kennedy Manning. And that is her first field goal for the sophomore out of Stone Mountain, Arabia Mountain High School, where last season in her freshman campaign, she averaged nearly 11 points and 7 rebounds a game for Augusta. And she'll have an opportunity for a 3-point play following this timeout on the floor. It comes with 4:32 left to play. 51-39, the Jaguars trailing in this contest. They were outscored 23-11 in the first, and then outscored in the second 17-15. Our halftime score was 40-26, as there was a scoring discrepancy. The official score across the way rewarded Augusta with an extra point, and we were able to help settle that number. Along with the Georgia Southern sports information folks that are to my left, they had the same score I had. Good opportunity for these officials to get some work as well. Everybody kind of getting back in the swing of basketball. As many of you guys that follow me on social media know I also do the play-by-play for Laney High School here in the Augusta area, and it's good to see Jaden Hamilton back on the floor. She practiced here on numerous occasions just before her team made a run toward a state championship. Jaden, number 12 on the floor for Georgia Southern. As Kennedy Manning, the other outstanding sophomore. His freshman and sophomore class on both sides are looking awfully good. And getting some valuable minutes here as they work the passing game. It's Nisbet finding a teammate on the wing. They come up top. There's Hamilton for three. Left wing no good. Rebound is swatted out of there and taken right out of the air by Kennedy Manning. So Manning with two fouls, not worried about it. As there's Harrison, West. They've got Morton on the right wing. You've got Bolden and Manning, the five on the floor for Augusta. 4 minutes left to go in the third. Opportunity cut it to single digits. Harrison with 6 seconds. They go to Bolden, 5 seconds. Bolden on the power drive to the basket. Lefty layup is good. Ashley Bolden having a game. She's got 15. And the Jaguars are down by 9. Left wing. Dribble penetration. Rejected inside by Manning. And that, oh my goodness, there's another one of those. Kennedy Manning, who waited for the ball to go in the air. She's got great anticipation skills. And she swatted that one cleanly. And the offensive player lost her balance as a result of that aggressive block. And when she fell to the floor, the official who was behind the play, second time we've seen that, call what looked to be a clean block. As now Tatum Barber will step up to the line, the senior from Dallas. She's got 3 points now. She was the leading scorer last season for her squad, averaging 12 points and 6 rebounds. She's got a lot of help offensively this season, which will certainly lighten the load for Tatum. She makes 2 here. She's got 4 in the contest. 53-42, back up to an 11-point lead. And now a steal by Barber. So that senior leadership on the defensive end, see if it leads to a basket. Nisbet. Foul line jump shot. That's strong. Loose ball, ball deflected, and it will be knocked out of bounds. And it'll be retained by Georgia Southern. They'll go up to the top of the key. Now Hamilton, free throw, jump shot. That's strong, and rebounded by Harrison. She got a hit ahead. It's Ashley Bolin all the way to the basket. Ashley pump fakes, lays it up, count the basket, and a foul. Hesitation move by Ashley Bolin. And she is having an afternoon to remember. 17 points now for Ashley. Only the second missed free throw shot for Ashley. Left wing 3, no good. Rebounded inside, blocked. Second try is up and good. I believe that was Barber. She's got 6 now. And now a turnover. That's a 3-on-1 to the basket. It misses the layup, but there's Hamilton with the follow-up. So Jaden Hamilton, the young lady out of Laney High School, or as they like to say down these parts, straight out of Laney, with her first field goal. She started 21 games, averaging 7 points and 3 rebounds a contest, with 33 made three-pointers had a season high, 25 points on 7 made threes in a game against Arkansas State. And as I mentioned, with her and Deja Hamilton and Jessica Williams, a formidable trio as they captured two state titles along the way. Zaria West on the board again. She's got three here in the second half. Five overall. So we've got a clock situation I think they were trying to resolve. The assistant coach who's acting as the head coach in this one said, oh, come on. He thought that was going to be whistled against them, but not to be the case, as now Jalen Altman will check back in. She'll come in for Zaria West. So West will check out. And on the dribble drive, inside move, there's a whistle from behind. Had the reverse opportunity there, but decided to go on the strong side. Did Simone James, and James will now go to the line to shoot two. James, the freshman out of San Diego, we mentioned in the first half with 5 points. First time at the line. And missed the second one. Rebounded inside and pulled out of there by Altman. Harrison races in the front court. Gets it to Lane. And then on the sideline, the baseline, you had Kiara Howard straddling it too closely. 58-46, 12-point game. Augusta had gotten it as low as 9. Would like to cut it into single digits by the end of this quarter. As there's a strong drive by the outstanding score from just a few days ago on Wednesday, as a matter of fact. 25 big points, and she has her first field goal here. And that was Golden. And now a steal. Hamilton with the hit ahead, stolen back by Harrison. Asia surveying the defense as she works against the All-State prospect from a couple of years ago, Hamilton. Now pull up, jump shot, knocking it down is Altman. Hope Mills, North Carolina, Grays Creek High School, the junior, Jalen Altman. 60-48, and there's a collision underneath. Now Ashley Boland will come in. She'll spell the junior, redshirt junior, Jalea Gray. Golden at the line. She knocks down a pair. So she left the SEC in Arkansas for the Sun Belt Conference in Georgia Southern. And now cross-court pass helps to break that three-quarter court press. Double team. Dribble drive, pick up the basketball, and then they don't call a contact, they call a traveling violation. ...62-48, 14 point edge, and the basketball for Georgia Southern. Top of the circle, three ball in the air, front iron no good, ball tipped. Nesbitt passes to a teammate and through her hands and out of bounds. Zaria West quickly off the bench for Augusta. She comes in for Altman. Kiara Howard. Hit ahead pass into the hands of Lane. Lane goes cross court to Boland. Boland double team. And it looks like they called a traveling violation against Boland. Nearly a foul there by Howard. Driving the lane, now the kick. Extra pass, one more. In the post, turn and face off the window and score. That's Vickers. She's got 7 in the second half, 12 overall. 64-48 as they work the ball in the front court. 5 seconds remaining. Zaria West, pull-up jump shot. Side rim, no good, rebounded. And that's the end of the third quarter. 30 minutes in the books. Christenberry Fieldhouse. A non-conference affair. It is Division I Georgia Southern leading Division II Augusta University 64-48. And this is the AUGB ball game of the week.
Seven, eleven, and four is 15
and yeah.
Seven, nine.
Following the timeout, Augusta opens up the fourth quarter with a made basket. And coming back the other end, the foul against Kennedy Manning in the post. Eden Johnson at the line. She's got 5 now. Make that 6. Michella Davis will check in. Kennedy Manning will get a break. Picked up that big foul right there. Manning now with 4 fouls One more. She's disqualified. 3-on-1 as they get it inside. Michaela Davis got the ball deflected. Thought it was a foul, and now she's trying to chase down the ball handler. Left wing for three. Rebounded, and here comes Augusta again. Looking like they had numbers. Now they'll have to slow it up. Wide open is Morton. They work it down low. Bolin. And Bolin travels. We'll have two games for you this coming week on SUV TV. Looking forward to bringing them to you. Fill you in as the afternoon rolls on. But go ahead and make plans. Wednesday and Saturday, two home games upcoming. Turn and face off the window. There's a whistle, and that'll be an offensive foul against Georgia Southern. Golden, I think, picked up that last foul on the dribble penetration move. Davis has it. Puts it in the hands of Howard. Howard surveying the defense. Davis pops up. She's wide open. She gets it at the top of the circle. Goes left wing. Now Zaria West got a ball screen. They go cross court to Howard. Down low to Bolin. Bolin trying to grab control. She does. Lefty hook up. No good, but there's a whistle. And a foul, and it'll be Bolin back at the line. Four of six from the line so far is Bolin. 66-50 is our score, 16-point advantage. Augusta had cut it to 9 here in the second half. The largest lead was 17 in this ball game. Second one in the air, and it's pure. So Ashley Bolin now with a game-high 18 points and nearly a steal. Ball deflected off her hip, I think, out of bounds back to Georgia Southern. And they'll trigger over the top, and there's a steal by Morton. November Morton racing ahead of the field. She lays it up and down. So what a debut for the transfer from Florida Institute of Technology. November Morton, 5 here in the second half. She's got 13 overall. And what a great job of rebounding by this Georgia Southern squad as they'll have a third attempt at the rim. We talked about that disparity in that first half as far as rebounding, and it's reared its ugly head again. Had an 8 rebounding advantage. Now they got a fresh 20-second clock to work with. Love Hill with the pull-up, and it's rejected by Howard, who goes all the way to the sideline, and they'll say 20-second shot clock violation, or just a shot clock violation. 20 is what they started with. As, of course, multiple possessions brings it back to the reset at 20. And now Maya Burns will check in. And out will go Taryn Ward. So Ward leaves, not scoring here in the second half. The co-player of the year in Warren
in Wayne County. She's got three in the ball game, making her debut. 66-53, and then it nearly a steal. It is a steal. Maya Burns to the basket. North Augusta's finest scores right there. So welcome home, Maya Burns, her first field goal. Howard with the right heat layup, no good. Left wing, bounce pass into the post. Getting deep position and scoring, number 41, Eden Johnson. Six here in the second half for her, eight overall in the ball game. She scored double figures with 12 points and three rebounds on 5 of 6 shooting. And they're lost to Jacksonville State as Michella Davis scores back for Augusta, her second field goal. She's got 5 now. And Georgia Southern running and gunning as Eden Johnson will go back to the line. Unselfish is this Georgia Southern team. They've got a lot of weapons offensively, and they're going to be a handful for their opponents in the Sun Belt Conference. Wholesale substitutions off of Millette Green's bench. So Johnson at the line, and she knocks down the first. Perfect 3 for 3 for her on the afternoon. Now she's in double figures with 10. So Eden Johnson comes out of nowhere. Climb up the ladder to second leading scorer in the ball game. Vickers, number 30, has 12. And those are the two double-digit scores. Wide open, three ball, left side. Front iron no good. Davis with the loose ball rebound. Outside. Harrison for 3. That's no good. Back to that 17-point deficit. 72-55 as they try to find Freeman, and the ball's behind her. 2-on-1. Fast break. Pump fake and a rejection out of bounds by Maya Burns. Asia Harrison. We need somebody to trigger on the sideline for Augusta. They're changing the ball out. So it'll be baseline out of bounds. And Harrison will trigger. Gets in the post to Davis. Outside it goes to Altman. Off to Harrison. Dribble penetration. Now the dump to Davis, who lost control of the basketball. Nice look it was. So we reached the 5-minute mark. Midway through the fourth period. Burns nearly lost control. Now she'll regain. Goes strong with the left hand. Puts up a shot. No good. Ball tipped. And out of bounds off Augusta. And we've got a media timeout, comes with 4:50 left to play. 17-point deficit for Augusta. 72-55 is our score. This is the AUGB Ball Game of the Week, and we've got two games of the week coming your way on Wednesday, December 2nd. Next Wednesday, the men are in action. We'll get a chance to see their talented men's program under the direction of Dip Mitras. We brought you their first practice on SUV TV and YouTube. Got a chance to meet all the players and talk with them at length. And watch Dip Mitras go through his coaching clinic, his annual coaching clinic, virtually this year. But they'll take on Lander at 6 p.m. And then on Saturday, we'll be right back here Saturday afternoon for another big matchup. This time, the opponent for the women will be UNC Pembroke. That'll be a big day for yours truly, because following that game, we'll head on down to Laney and bring you Laney and Cross Creek for those folks that follow high school basketball in this area, both men and women. It won't get much better than that matchup. And you know that Millette Green will have her women well prepared. So 2 p.m. on the 5th. 5:30 on the 5th is the matchup that we'll be bringing you. And the Eagles with a foul committed gives the ball back. So 17-point deficit. Still plenty of time left in the game. You got to get some stops and knock down some field goals. As that one's deflected, and a deflection out of the timeout is exactly what Coach did not want to see as she looks over to the bench. And here's a steal back, Morton. So if you lose the ball, you got to get it back as Morton will pull up with the one hand. November Morton taking full advantage of this opportunity to play in her month. And she's got 15. What a debut for her. No look pass, but a travel comes before it. Lydia Freeman was wide open in the paint. Galdinell will check in. Nisbet will also come back in. Freeman will check out after a brief time on the floor. Contact, no whistle. Against West, Manning on the floor with those four fouls. Extra pass, Lane has it, brings it up top. Harrison, now down low to Kennedy. Extra pass with 8 seconds on the clock. There's the pull-up jump shot, it's knocked down by Zaria West. So West now has eight. 13-point lead, Georgia Southern. Galdin. Throws it over the top. Nice look in the paint. Loose ball picked back by her teammate. Finds her on the wing. Now the elbow jump shot is up, no good. Loose ball rebound and an easy opportunity. Second try, and there's a whistle and a foul as the big goes down hard. Sarah Moore. You have to earn these from the free throw line. One for one from the line for her on the day. Looking to climb into double figures. She makes the second, so she's got 10. 10 for Johnson. 12 in the game for Vickers. Leading scorers for Georgia Southern. Augusta's been led by Ashley Boland with 18 points. 15 in the game for November Morton. On the wing. Three ball in the air. It's halfway down. It pops out. Rebound. No good. Rebounded by Morton. Looks inside, now outside on the wing. It's West for three. Rattled halfway down and popped out into the hands of Morton. She couldn't hold on to it. And Augusta's still trailing by 14 inside of 3 minutes left. Galdin taken out of there by Morton. She's awfully tough defensively. Now on the wing. Harrison, stop and pop. Front iron no good. There's Morton with the follow-up, and she knocks it in. I like this girl, Morton. She is a tough competitor. 17 now for her. Back the other way is Jaden Hamilton. Speaking of tough competitors, Hamilton, her second field goal. She's got four. Still a 14-point lead. 2 minutes left. West. Out to Morton. She's going to pull up. Morton halfway down. Now Hamilton in the front court. Working against West. Bounce pass to Nisbet. Misfires there. Morton. West. Harrison. Manning turns and faces. Goes with that lefty hook, and it's good. Off the window. Knocking that one down is Kennedy Manning for just her second field goal. She's got five. All here in the second half. Nisbet. They got 3 seconds to get it across. 2 seconds. They get it across. Now on the wing. Hamilton wants it. Side of the rim and backboard, no good. Kept alive in the hands of Manning. Now a fast break, 2-on-1. To the basket, the left hand deflected out of bounds by the youngster. Lacey Robbins playing strong defense. Point game, 11:54 seconds rather remaining in the game. There's a three, and it's no good by Gray. Georgia Southern. Pull up jump shot, no good. Loose ball, out of bounds off Augusta, and it'll be Georgia Southern basketball with 35.6 remaining. Inbounds to the top of the key. Hamilton. Nisbet on the power drive. And then she travels. She held the ball behind and couldn't gather it in. Asia Harrison finds a teammate on the wing. Zaria West for three. That's strong. Love Hill down low. Nisbet to the free throw line. Pulling up. That's deflected. And that may be all for Kennedy Manning. To Kennedy Manning, fouls out. The Peach Belt Conference third team member from a year ago in a freshman campaign got it done. But today was a learning experience for her. Last year, averaging nearly 11 points and 7 rebounds, she was held in check to 5 today. Vickers at the line. They thought it was a 1-1, but she was in the act of shooting. So she gets a second opportunity and knocks that down. 13 points in the ball game for her. And Augusta fortunate enough to keep the possession. And we've got a timeout on the floor with 5.6 seconds remaining. I guess just enough time for the student trainers to start gathering up their materials and prepare to head on the bus back to Statesboro. As we mentioned, Georgia Southern next up for them on Thursday, December 3rd, is their home opener. It will be at Hannah Fieldhouse, a 6 p.m. contest versus Furman. That game will be available on ESPN Plus, as was the Jacksonville game. This one on the Peach Belt Conference Network and Augusta University Television. And it's powered by AUGB Ball. Great job to our director, Seth, and his fine crew. Worked tirelessly toward this one. As the final seconds, Harrison throws it away, and they won't get a chance to get a shot off in time. And it wasn't to be, and it wouldn't matter anyway. The final score this afternoon, Georgia Southern, 76, and the Jaguar women, 63. So we touched on it coming into the game. When these two teams match up, the average score is 76 to 55. So Augusta doing 8 better this time, which I think speaks volumes. And let's see what happens here, as oftentimes, especially in this new normal, you don't have shaking of hands following a game. Just the coaches will shake, and that is the case here. So not sure why we didn't get a chance to see Coach Howard, but we wish her the best in the holiday season. And of course, we got a chance to see the new look AU Lady Jaguars, who look really, really sharp at times in this game. Some things to definitely clean up in terms of turnovers. But nonetheless, I think it's something that we can build upon as we face the Division I opponent, holding them right at where they averaged from last season, and more importantly, seeing what they're capable of doing as they move forward and what is ahead for both teams. An outstanding season. I think we know that Georgia Southern, with the additional height and length, will be a talented group and a team that will have to be contended with in the Sun Belt. And again, in the Peach Belt, you know there's very talented teams on this Division II level. And Augusta will have their hands full. But I think they'll be up for the task as long as these two players continue to shine offensively. Ashley Bolin, I dare say a career high, 18 points today on 6 of 8 shooting, 5 of 8 from the free throw line, 1 for 1 from 3-point land. She was terrific in her performance, and then the newcomer. And man, did this young lady get it done as well. We're talking about number 30, November Morton, the 5'10 junior out of Tampa, Florida, and Florida Institute of Technology. Prolific scorer, as we heard, in high school, averaging 21 points a game. Well, in her Augusta debut, she finished up with 17 points on 7 of 9 shooting, 3 of 4 from 3-point land. She had 3 rebounds in the ball game as well. So outstanding performance for them. And on the other opposite side, we got a chance to see some great work done on the part of Georgia Southern, as they did a wonderful job indeed. And we'll see what we have here on the Georgia Southern stat side. They were paced by Vickers, number 30, with 13 points. Johnson had 10. And Moore with 10 points as well. The local products in the game: Burns had 4 points on 1 of 5 shooting, 2 of 2 from the free throw line, and Hamilton with 6 points on 3 of 9 shooting, 0 of 4 from 3-point land. Hamilton also with 3 rebounds and 2 assists in the contest. Burns had 5 rebounds and 2 assists in the game. And again, your final score, 76-63, Georgia Southern victorious. So for the entire crew, stewarded by Seth and his outstanding staff, and for my broadcast partner Chad Cook and AUGB Ball, we want to thank you for tuning in to this exclusive coverage of AU basketball. Our next contest again will be on December 2nd, and the men are in action against Lander. That is a 6 o'clock start, and then the 5:30 next Saturday will be on the air to bring you the women in action against UNC Pembroke. For everybody associated, I'm the Mac Daddy, Charles McNeil. Get out to the church of your choice tomorrow or watch it virtually, and we'll hope to have you right back here next time. Good afternoon, good night, and God bless everyone.